नवलक्षण लक्षितं श्रीकृष्णाक्षं परम धाम जगद्धाम नमामि तं हृदयस्य प्रेरणया प्रवर्तितोऽहं वरानुगोपी तस्य हरे पदकमलं वन्दे श्रीचैतन्यदेवस्य अनर्पितचरीञ्चरात्तरुणयावतीर्णकलौ समर्पयतोन्नतोज्ज्वलरसां स्वहृदिश्रियं हरिपुरसुन्दरद्विकलं न सन्दीप्तः सदा हृदय कंदरे स्फुरतो शचीनंदन जयतां सरदौ पंगो मन्मते गति मत्सर्वस्वदाम्भोजौ श्रीराधामदनमोहनौ नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वती व्यासं ततो जयन्तीरये वाञ्छातिभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च भक्तानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः हे श्री सनातन प्रभु करुणाम्बुराशे हे रूप दुर्गत जनैक दयावलोक हे भक्ति सुमते रघुनाथ दास श्री जीव मे कुरुत मंद मते दयांतरा तुलसी कानन यत्र यत्र पद्मनाम च पुराण पठनम यत्र तत्र सन्निहितो बिकम्स लेसन देन द चित्त बिकेम वेरी मच प्योर एंड प्योर चित्र चित्त ज्ञान एंड भक्ति बोथ एमिट्स इट्स रिजल्ट एमिट्स इट्स इट्स देमसेल्फ सो परहैप्स इट हैज बीन डन बट in the 10th chapter 14th verse we are going to discuss there is two schools of philosophy one school says that it is advaitavad there is nothing else than brahm And whatever duality is being done, seen, that is due to the illusion. But the other school of thought, philosophy is this, that there are separate things, many things, And they are also eternal. So they are Dvaitavadi. Advaitavadi and Dvaitavadi. In Advaitavadi, unduality who accepts, they also have two ways, two schools. One school is, they say that whatever 20 is being seen, that is due to illusion. But the other Vaishnavas, other school of unduality, they say no, the tattva is one, but that tattva is always with action, and that tattva has the quality of qualities. It is with quality and action. So Sri Shankaracharya, so we can understand it, story in Shankaracharya and Vaishnava. Shankaracharya, they says that there is only one thing, that is Brahma, and the duality that is being seen, that is due to the illusion. But the other Advaitavadi, either he is Vishuddhadvait, or he is Shuddhadvait, or he is Dvaitadvait, or he is Achintadvait, they all say that no, the duality that is being seen, it is the power of Sri Krishna, power of that Paratattva. So the unduality is obtained, but unduality also has the quality that Paratattva is with action and qualities. So the Shakti can be manifest out of the Brahma, as well as it can be manifested within the Brahma. It can be lived in the Brahma, and it can be also sometimes manifest as the second thing, as the dwell, as the other than Swarup Shakti, it is also can be seen. Shakti Parinam, that is Shakti Parinam Vadi, is just this Brahma has its Shakti, it is not without Shakti. Shakti Parinam means Brahma is not doing, not manifesting things, he is making Shakti to manifest other things, that is Shakti Parinam. Brahma is making his Shakti to manifest the other things, many things, that is Shakti Parinam. Brahma is not directly doing it, he is making his Shakti manifesting in many things. As a household person is not making the house, it is made by labor, but it is called that household person, the house master, he has created the house. So that is Shakti. So in this way we can understand the three types. One is there is nothing else than Brahma, and whatever duality is being seen, that is due to the illusion. The other person says, the second thought is this, that no, Brahma, we accept that Brahma is only thing and nothing is else than Brahma, but Brahma has many power within him and he makes Shaktis to manifest other things, and he is full of Shakti. So that absolute reality, absolute Paratattva, is not without power, or it is not nirgun, but it has all gun within it, and it has all qualities and actions within it. That is the second one. The third one is says that no, there is three things or two things. There is three things. One is Brahma, he is also eternal. The jeev, he is also eternal, and the Maya, she is also eternal. And these two, whole three things are separate and they are eternal.
So they are Dvaitvadi. Dvaitvadi, by duality, full of duality. Samcha, by Sheshek, as well as Nyaya and Mimamsa. These four schools of darshan, of philosophy, are Dvaitvadi. And they say that Prakriti is a separate thing and Brahma is a separate thing, and both are eternal. And when a jeev or purush will get himself released from Maya, then it will be his moksha. But Maya will remain there. But the other persons says no, Maya is a Shakti of Brahma, and by Swarup Shakti Maya will be discarded and Swarup Shakti will come, and then Jeev will experience the sweetness of Shri Krishna or that absolute reality by Swarup Shakti. So that is the other thing. And now, Dvaitvadi Darshan and Advaitvadi Darshan. Mainly, Sri Shankaracharya sometimes criticize and he discard the theory of Dvaitvadi Darshan, man Sankhya Darshan. In Sankhya Darshan, this is described that jeev are numberless, many. Jeev are many. We Vaishnava accept that Tatastha Shakti is one, and in the form of vritti, in the form of expansion of that Tatastha Shakti, we are so many jeev. But they say there is no need of thinking the jeev tatastha shakti. You take every jeev as a separate entity. So Dvaitvadi Darshan, Sankhya says that jeev are many. So first of all, to understand this verse, we should understand the theory of Sankhya Tattva, Sankhya Shastra. Sankhya says that Janma Maran Karananam Prithiniyamat Ayukpat Prabhuteshya Purush Bhautam Siddham. There are so many jeev, Purush Bhautam. Not Tatastha Shakti is one and the Vritti is many. We accept in this way, we Vaishnava accept that Tatastha Shakti is one, and as the vritti of, as the expansion of Tatastha Shakti, we are so many jeev. But in group, we are Tatastha Shakti. Sankhya Shastra says that every jeev is individual. And for they give some arguments. Janma Maran Karananam Prithiniyamam. Every jeev is taking separate birth. He is dying separately. If one person is died, the whole Srishti, creation will die. It is not possible. If one person is born, then whole Srishti will born. This is not fine. So Janma Maran and Karanana. Karan means whatever one person is doing, the other person is not doing, other jeev is not doing. One person is eating and other person is sleeping. So our actions are as different. So we will say that jeev are many. Jeev are in numbers. They are not one. So Janma Karan Maranam Prithiniyamam. every prithiniyam. That means every person is separately taking janma, separately he is dying, and separately he is doing dava. Ayopat pravrutesho, they are not doing one. Because if you will think that a person, then how? If they are one, then how Vamdev get the salvation? And if Vamdev have get the salvation, then Devdutt should automatically get the salvation. So this is the problem. एक की मुक्ति होने पर सबकी मुक्ति हो जाएगी, एक का बंधन होने पर किसी की भी मुक्ति नहीं हो सकती है, पंत ऐसा प्राप्त नहीं है, इसलिए जीव अनेक होनी चाहिए, ये उन्होंने कहा। तो जन्म मरण करना नाम पुतनीय मार्ग अयुपत्र पृष्ठ पुरुष बहुतम सिद्धम मुक्त कैवल्यार्थम प्रवृत्तेश्च। वन पर्सन इज डूइंग एफर्ट to get moksha, but other person is not doing, and he is not getting moksha. So by one action of one person, the other person is not benefited, the same person is benefited. So this will be said that jeev ar bahu. Shri Shankaracharya has to accept this thing. And he has explained this thing. Well, yes, you are right. In vritti, we are different. But in tattva, we are one. Shankaracharya also says, as B. Vaishnav says, in the same way, Shankaracharya also says that in tattva, everything is Brahma. But in maya vritti, every jeev is different. But we say, every jeev is different. In tattva, he is tatastha shakti, but every jeev is different. And now he is saying the same theory, same argument is given in this fourth verse. Ke athaisham karma kartrinam bhoktrinam sukh dukhyo. Among these jeev, many persons are doing work. They all are karma kartri. They are doing various works. And if a person is trying to get salvation, to get the moksha, then he only will get moksha. The other person will be remained tied. So karma kartrinam, so one vyakti who is doing karma, he will get the bandhan. The other person who is leaving karma and doing the jnan sadhan or bhakti sadhan, he will getting the moksha and Shri Krishna seva. In the same way, bhoktrinam sukh dukhayo. Normally it is seen that we are experiencing sukh and dukh, both. A person is happy, the other person is not happy. So that means the jeev are different. Jeev are not one. Bhoktiram sukh dukhayo. Nanatvam. They are the nanatvam. They are the separate. Nanatvam. Atha nityatvam. Even then, they are nitya. No problem. Nanatvam atha nityatvam. Jeev are many, in many numbers. Atha nityatvam. Even then, if the jeev is nitya, he says that if the jeev is nitya, then how he can get the salvation? Because if the Maya is Nitya, then Maya cannot live. One other, in Shankaracharya Mata, there is no jiva. Actually, the wrapped by Maya, Brahma, which is the portion of Brahma that is wrapped by Maya, it is called jiva. So, Maya is, if the Maya is Nitya, then there cannot be salvation at any moment. Though we will try for 100,000 years, even one cannot get the moksha. Because if the Maya is Nitya, then the eternal thing cannot be destroyed, discarded. So, this is the question. And now, what is the answer? The answer is this, that we will accept Sri Brahma as the whole entity. Param Tattva Ektam, Advaita, he is the undual entity. Absolute reality. He is the absolute reality, absolute entity. And as the absolute reality, Brahma is, but he is full of so many Shakti. And in their Shakti, there are the comparison. One Shakti is much more powerful and other Shakti is less powerful. So the powerful Shakti, Swarup Shakti, can defeat the Bahiranga Shakti and Maya Shakti. So, first powerful Shakti is Swarup Shakti, then the other powerful Shakti is Jeev Shakti, and the less Maya Shakti, and the less powerful Shakti is Jeev Shakti. So, Maya Shakti can surpass or defeat Jeev Shakti, but Maya Shakti cannot defeat Swarup Shakti. So, Brahma is with Shaktis, and in among those Shaktis, Shakti is omnipotent power. There is the comparison. There is less and more. It is uchavach, higher and lower position are still there. हाँ तो माया माया इतनी पराशक्ति है कि वो जीव को मोहित कर सकती है इस दृष्टि से जीव क्योंकि अणु है A jeev is atom, so Maya is so powerful that it can surpass and it can suppress jeev and can cover the jeev, not to the Ishwar. ये अंतर हो जाएगा. जीव की अपेक्षा माया श्रेष्ठ माने माया ज्यादा ताकतवर है. जीव ताकतवर तब होगा जबकि वो भक्ति से युक्त हो जाए. नहीं जीव तो जीव मैं दूसरी दृष्टि से देखेंगे तो जीव श्रेष्ठ है. जीव इसलिए श्रेष्ठ है कि जीव जड़ नहीं है वो चेतन है. तो चेतन की दृष्टि से तो श्रेष्ठ है परंतु जड़ पदार्थ भी भगवान की शक्ति से शक्तिमान होकर के वो माया को मोहित कर जीव को मोहित कर सकता है. यद तो यहां पर कह रहे हैं कि नानात्वम अति नित्यत्वम जीव एंड माया बोथ आर इफ दे आर इटर्नल देन द माया कैन नॉट बी रिमूव्ड एवर लोक काला गला धर्मात्मना एंड द जीव आर वर्किंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द लोक मनी फोक टेंडेंसी एंड काल अकॉर्डिंग टू टाइम and according to Adam. Sometimes he works according to the customs, loka. Sometimes he works according to the kal. And sometimes he works according to the Adam, according to the shastra. And by that, jeev gets sukha and dukha. So, by maya, by he is saying that in this way. If we will consider Jeev as a separate tattva, an eternal tattva, separate, eternal, powerful tattva, then it cannot be discarded. So Sri Krishna is saying that though Jeev is nitya, even then it is, he is tini, he is atom, and Maya can also defeat him, and as well as he can also defeat Maya if he gets bhakti, and then he will get the Sri Krishna Madhurya, and he will become free from the material sutta. But some persons are busy in corporal activities, and some persons are busy to get relief from the worldly sensual activities, and they are trying to get Bhagavad Bhakti. So if he will get Bhagavad Bhakti or Gyan, then he will get relief from the worldly ties. So nanatva loka manne se sarvahana sanstha upatti ki yatha tattadakrit bhedena jayate vidyate chiti. Now Sri Krishna is again saying, so that means we should accept the Advaita Marga, and we also, we all Vaishnavas also accept Advaita Marga, but in Advaita there is Dvaita. Though Brahma is all, even then in Shakti there are various Shakti, and various Shakti has different between one Shakti is diverse to other Shakti. We accept this, but in whole, in cross, we are Advaita Marga. Achintya Bheda Bheda. Actually it is Abheda, but in diversity in unity, we accept this. In the same way, now he is saying that some person says that Maya is also eternal. So there are three things, Jiva, Brahma and Maya. He has accepted, he has decided that some person says that he has given the question, Guru Paksha, that if Jiva are one, then by the salvation of one Jiva, the whole Jiva should be get salvation. And if one is, only a single person is still bounded, then there will be no salvation of any person, because Jiva is one. So he is saying in this way. In the same way, now he is discussing, this is Puru Paksha, this is also Puru Paksha. Sri Krishna is saying that material science says that a thing cannot be destroyed absolutely, finally. It only changes. The concrete things changes into, sometimes into the water, a liquid, and liquid changes into gas. So thos drav gas, thos drav gas, the thing can be transformed into other form, but the thing cannot be destroyed. The pitcher is broken, but it is not destroyed. It has taken the form of a clay, form of dust. So that dust can be again be mixed, and that can create a vow. So it's a form is changed. In the same way, the water is transformed in the form of gas, and the gas or the bhap can be again converted into the water, and water can be converted into the ice. So drip, thos, gas, these are found. So this is also a very special thing that so manne se sarvanam sanstha yogpatti ki yatha. If you think that everything is to be destroyed, but that destruction is only the change of the form, utpatti ki yatha, as a thing is being born, in the same way the thing is being destroyed, but the thing is one. Tat tadakrit bhedena, only it is transforming the akriti. Gas is changing into the liquid, liquid is changing into the concrete, but akriti is changed. The thing cannot be absolutely finally destructed. In this way, jayate vidyate chidhi, actually the thing is not destroyed, our gyan is destroyed. Jayate vidyate chidhi, our knowledge is being born, and knowledge is being destroyed, the thing is not destroyed. As the water change into the bhap, kya bhap, 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 gas,
vapor,
vapor, vapor, vapor, vaporing, gas, vapor, vaporing. So as water is changing into the vapor, so Shri, one person can say that no, the thing is not destroyed and thing is not born, but your buddhi is born and the previous knowledge was destroyed. As we are saying that I am taking bath and dipping in the same river, wrong. Yesterday when I took bath and dipped in a river, that river is not here, that has gone far, far miles away from this place. We cannot put our place again in the same river. So jayate vidyate chadhi, actually our buddhi is if we are continuing our buddhi, then it is continuous gyan, that is saying that it is the same thing, but the same thing is never found, same thing is not never found, but our gyan parampara, that is always found. And this gyan parampara shows that this thing is everlasting. Nothing is Bodh Dharma is also describes in this way that we have a sequence, that this is a kartal. This is a kartal, this is a kartal, this is a kartal. This continuous, this stream of knowledge is being experienced, and then that continuous knowledge is saying that this kartal is here. And this kartal is, this is the same kartal. But actually saying, we have the continuity, we have the a great sequence of knowledge. And that sequence combined shows that the thing is here. This is the same flames, same flame, same stream. And we are saying this is one lamp. But the lamp is not, that is not the one lamp, that is the so many. So lamp is there, but our gyan is always changing. And we have the sequence of gyan, a sequence of experience we are always having. And that sequence combinedly, compoundly showing that this thing is one and it is stable. But that is not, neither that is stable and neither that is, that thing is one. Every day, every moment we are getting the new knowledge, and the on the second the new knowledge is coming, and because they are some similarity, so we are saying that this is the same thing. So that is the same thing. So मंदिर से सर्वहानम संस्था उत्पन्न किया तब तदाकृति भेद देनो दो एट एवरी मोमेंट एवरीथिंग इज चेंजिंग जायते भिद्यते चिधि बट दे आर सम सिमिलरिटी सो ड्यू टू दैट सिमिलरिटी एंड दैट टू ज्ञान परंपरा अविच्छिन्न ज्ञान घटोयम 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 दिस इज पिक्चर 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 दिस इज सीक्वेंस is saying that this is the picture. But ghatoyam ghatoyam ye gyan parampara, every day gyan parampara is, every moment the new gyan is being manifesting and the other gyan is dying. But combinedly that gyan becomes one. So he is saying that neither jeev is cannot be, jeev cannot be considered. A jnani will say, neither a jeev can be considered separate. We cannot consider that whole jeev are in many numbers. If we are doing, saying that jeev are many, then we cannot prove that there is salvation. The salvation cannot be possible. So we have to accept that this duality is due to illusion, and if the illusion is destroyed, then the jeev can be merged into the Brahman. And the duality, one is released and one is still bounded. That is our illusion. Ye Shankaracharya kahenge. And Bhakti will say that we have the same quality of Tathastha Shakti. We are Anu. Even then we are separate, and being separate by Bhakti or by Gyan, a person can get release, and by one salvation of liberation of one person, the liberation of every jeev will not commence. So other persons will remain bounded, but a one person will get the release of mind. And in the same way, Sri Shankaracharya is saying that whatever duality is being seen, that is due to the illusion. That this is a cloth and this is the food. That is, and this is the tree. So this type of duality that is seen, but it is due to the illusion. The Nyaya Shastra will say that Dharavahi Gyan, a technical term is Dharavahi Gyan, Ghatoyam, 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 this sequence, this knowledge of sequence compoundly gives the image that the ghat is one and now I am seeing the ghat, but we are not seeing the ghat, and the time of present is very 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 limited. It is only a point and we will proceed on the way, proceed on the path. So tattadakrita bhedena jayate vidyate chati, tattadakrita bhedena jayate vidyate chati, we are actually saying we are not taking bath in the same river, we are not seeing the same flame. Every moment the new flame is coming and the other flame is extinguishing, but we say this flame is continuous, this flame is akhanda dipa, it is not broken, unbroken flame, but it is not unbroken. In this way, the one thing is there, we person will modify it, we Vaishnava will modify it, that though Shri Krishna is powerful, even then Brahma is only one, even then Brahma has so many vritti, so many shakti, and in shakti there is difference between vritti to vritti. One manifestation to the other manifestation of one shakti. Shakti has manifested in many forms, and one manifestation is different to the other manifestation. So the liberation of only one person will be commenced, and by the liberation of one person, by the liberation of Shri Vamadev, Devadatta will not get liberated. That is the difference. Evam apyang sarvesham dehinam dehiyogatah kalavayavata santi bhava janmadayo asprat. In the same way, this can be also described. And they, both them, Nayayik, they also say that janmadayo asprat. Evam apyang sarvesham dehinam dehiyogatah. When a person, now the three things. In first, he has described the jivta. In second verse, he has described the jagat. He is saying that jagat is also eternal, and its form is being changed. And now the joining of a jiva and jagat is describing in this. Atrapi. Evam bhakyam sarvesham dehinam dehiyogatah. While a jiva will join to the jala padartha maya, then kala vyavartanti bhava janma, he will get jan, and by the prabhav of, by the effect of kal, time, he will get the transformation in the same body. As a unripe mango changes into the ripe mango, in the same way the jivatma has joined with jal padartha, then he became jan, he took jan. As a unanimated thing is joined with the animation, with the animated thing. Jar thing is joined to the chetan. So joining of a chetan with jar, animated with unanimated things, that will be called jan. And by the prabhav of kal, the thing will be changed, will be get changed. Jayate asti vardhate, these six transformation will be there. Janmadaya asti. But the thing is the same. The one time a child is infant, then he is child, he is kishore, he is young, he is a grown up person, and he is a old person. So this will be according to, so as by the effect of kal, we are made of three tattva, three gun, sattva rastam. As soon as the sattva gun will be lessened, and rayogun tamogun devi, tamogun will be lifted, upward, increased. So one thing is lessened and other thing is increased. Then gradually the change in the same thing will be commenced. So kalavayav tasanti, by kalavayav means mane every moment we are getting change. Bhava janmadeo askrit. Askrit means continuously, many times. Our janma ityadi getting every time. That means every moment we are taking birth, and at every moment we are dying. He is saying in this way, in every moment we are dying, in every moment we are taking birth. Because kal is just the circle of time is just going, and by the movement of that circle, sattva rastam is affected, and as soon as the tamogun will increase, the sattva gun will be lessened, and in this way the change will be there. हाँ बस ये बात है, वो पुराना बदलता जाएगा, नया आता जाएगा, और फिर ये समाप्त हो जाएगा, नया शरीर मिल जाएगा उसको, उसका जन्म हो जाएगा. अत्रापि कर्मणाम, अब माने श्री कृष्ण इस बात को सिद्ध करना चाह रहे हैं कि वास्तविक तत्व मैं हूं, और जितने भी तत्व हैं, जितने व्हाट एवर ड्यूअलिटी वी आर सीइंग, दैट ड्यूअलिटी इज due to my Shakti, and in cross I am the undual Advaita. This Shri Krishna want to prove. Atrapa karmanam kartu, and in the living position also, asvatram cha labhyate, a jeev is not fully Swatant, fully free. We are every time aswatant. We are every time bounded.
Subordinate.
We are subordinate. Yes, we are subordinate. I'm swatant, we are subordinate. तो कर्मणां कर्तुः अस्वातंत्रम्, एंड वी आर अनफ्री एट एवरी मोमेंट, वी आर अनफ्री. दैट मीन्स द ए फार्मर इज फार्मिंग विथ होल लेबर एंड होल इंटेलिजेंस, एंड ही इज फार्मिंग. He has sowed the seed, but he is not swatant. If the rain is there, then the cord will be increased. And if flood is coming, the grown up crop is also shattered. So he is always, we are always, every moment we are aswatantra. So he is saying that we should always remember that we are not swatantra. A person thinks that I am very much happy, I am very much swatantra, and I have no governance on me. But we are always in the governance of Shri Krishna, in the subordination. We are always in the subordination of Shri Krishna. So atrapi karmanam kartuho asvatantram cha labhyate. Sometimes a person is doing very few efforts and he is getting the great results, and sometimes he is doing the Herculean efforts and even then he is getting very few results. So this is it. So we are always aswatantra. At which time we will get the result and which time we will not be able to be sorrow or be, we will not get the required result. So bhoktishya sukhdukhayo kon bartho vipsho bhavi. In this way we are always experiencing sukh and dukh. Kon bartho vipsho bhavi, that means how we can realize the sukh. Actually we cannot realize the sukh finally. Kunvartha bhimshak, a person who is not free, who is a slave, that person how he can enjoy the sukh? Kunvartha bhimsho bhave, who is bivash, who is under control, how he can experience the sukh? So that means he is saying yes, हम तो कुल मिलाकर के भगवान, the final जो है वो तो भगवान ही है. ये काल काल नहीं है. काल और वेदर भी, we blame on वेदर. He will succeed. And if a person is not knowing the procedure of birth, then he will fail. This is one argument is again. This argument can be given that a person who is skillful and who knows the procedure, then he will get success. That means the success is based on one's education and one's knowledge. But no, this is also not found, because there are so many instances that na deinam sukham kichit vidyate bishamapi. A person is very clever, he is very educated, he is very intelligent and scholar, even then the person is getting so many difficulties. He has to face so many difficulties. So na deinam sukham kichit vidyate bishamapi. Though he is vidush, so he is very skillful and knowledgeful, even then a knowledgeful person is also not very skillful. A skillful person is also, a clever person is also getting the difficulties. And tathach dukham muranam vritha ahankaranam param. In the same way he is also getting the same dukh as it is of the unclever a limit. Isliye vritha ahankaranam param, this ego that I am a educated person, this is also vritha, this is also in pain. is of no use. So that is also ahankara. If a person is thinking that by knowledge, by skill, by our practice and study, I will get the sukh, that is also not found, because a mool person, a layman, is getting sukh, happiness, and a skilled person is also getting so many dukh. A doctor himself gets sick. So though he know everything, even then he gets sick. Yat praptim vighatam cha jananti sukh dukha yog te pradhyan vidur yogam mityur na prabhedya tha. And now Shri Krishna is saying that there are some persons who are clever and who has read that by doing this I shall get the result in return, good result in return. And if I will not do this, then my work will be full of hindrances and the result will be like I will get dukh. Even then, te pabdhyana vidur yogam, those clever persons, those expert persons, does not know mrityu na prabhavetyatha, that you will be not die. Nobody, no person knows that mrityu na prabhavet, the death will not be effective on me. He does not know, nobody knows this, though he is a thing to be very much wise. So even wise persons do not know how they can get rid of mrityu. Kon varta sukhyatyenam kama va mrityu rankake aghatam niya manasyo badhyasyevana tushtida. And if there is the fear of death, then how a person can experience the happiness? If a person is carried to be hanged, and at that time, so he is saying ki aghatam niya manasyo, if a person is carried on the slaughter, for slaughtering, for killing him, then badhyasyevana tushtidaha, and he is bound and he is presented, he is offered so many delicious things to use, he cannot get. In the same way, so far we will not get the remedy to get a remedy of death, we cannot be happy. So the remedy of the fear of death will be can be gotten only if a person is thinking that mrityu is not a thing of fear. Mrityu is of this body, it is not of soul, not of the spirit. Then he will get this. So Shri Krishna is saying in the same way, now the same thing is that a person should always have think of Shri Krishna, the ultimate result, and ultimate result is Shri Krishna. And we can get happiness only by Shri Krishna. The happiness of body that is not a cause of his eternal happiness. Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki jai. पांच सात इसमें बहुत कठिन बिल्कुल बहुत बढ़िया है
So, we are never Swatantra.
Ah, yes.
Now the question comes. Usually we say, we are either under the control of Maya or Yoga Maya. Right? But what about the person who goes to liberation in Brahman? To Jiva. He goes into Brahman. Under what control is this Jiva?
There is the control of Brahma will be always on the jiva. But he will not realize the beauty of Brahma. That is the meaning. That means in moksha there is three positions. One position is we are merged in the Brahma. One thing that as the drop is in ocean, but drop is not merged. It is an ocean, and due to the same features, it is conceived. So Jeev is also Satchitanand, and Brahma is also Satchitanand. So Jeev is concealed in the use Satchitanand, the Anujiv is conceived. One position. The second position is Jeev is also seen in Brahma, but it is unactivated as a straw is in the stream. But straw is not water, straw is straw. In the same way, Jeev is in Brahma, but he is not Brahma. That is it. So Jeev and Brahma are just like similar. They are Satchidanand, he is also Satchidanand, and in Satchidanand, Satchidananta of Jeev and Satchidananta of Brahma, those are different. Even then, apparently, they both are Satchitananda, and one Satchitananda is concealed by other Satchitananda, one position. The other, the difference of Jeev and Brahma is also there, but Jeev is not working. The third position is Jeev has got the Seva Swarup and he is serving. So, in this way. So, in Brahma, either in whole three positions, though we are, even then, we are in the control of Sri Brahma, and we are under thumb of Sri, under thumb of Brahma. So control is there, everywhere. Jeev is not so controlled.
When it's in Brahma, in the Nirvishesh Brahma, so to say.
Yes.
It's not Nirvishesh, it's
yes, Nirvishesh.
That, then, it is not directly Yoga Maya. Is it Yoga Maya?
No. Yoga Maya.
It's only Lila.
In theory, we will accept that Brahma is always full of so many Maya, and Yoga Maya is also there. Maya, so many powers, and the most prime Maya is Yoga Maya. And other Shaktis are under the control of Yoga Maya. We will accept it. But Yoga Maya is not very much manifesting its position.
Yes.
And in Bhakti, the manifestation, yes, that will become.
Yes.
In Bhakti,
because it is also said, if the impersonalist fails to continue his worship, then he will go down again and he will come altruist in this world. Is this Padanti Tat when they are. I don't fully remember this verse.
यहाँ ब्रह्मा 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 के पास में जाएंगे वो तुम्हारे या तावत पूर्ण होते स्वर्गम या ब्रह्मा इज ब्रह्मा नॉट ब्रह्म ब्रह्म फ्रॉम ब्रह्मा सत्य लोक द पर्सन विल कम रिटर्न फ्रॉम सत्य लोक ही
Bhagavatam is saying if they fail to worship because they think they are liberated, then they will come down again.
Mukta api punarvasana bhi aati. Mukti jo hai, wo punarvasana prapt ho jaati. Theek hai. Yadi Bhagwan ke virodhi hai, bhakti ka unhone chhod diya, to mukta hone par bhi ve vasana ko prapt ho jaati.